Hello, I'm Gail Ayers, the CEO of Crew Network, which is an organization for women in commercial real estate. We look forward to networking with many wonderful women, and I certainly have someone here today that fits that description. I know you'll enjoy hearing from Marcy Roussel. Marcy is a famous advocate of women. She is also an amazing economist and businesswoman. So I am delighted to have you here. Thank you, Marcy.
Thanks for having me, Gail.
I wanted to make sure that we give you a chance to kick off by saying, what do you think about this economy? Is it really, does the media make it sound worse than it is? Or is it better, really, than the media makes it sound?
Well, you got to remember that the media's job is to convey information, but they have to do it in a way that grabs people and makes it interesting. And unfortunately, what usually grabs our attention is negative news, not positive news. And so even though I believe it's the media's job to convey information, it's our job to sift through that and sometimes figure out what is the real story. And the real story right now, I believe, for the U.S. economy is much more positive than what we can imagine. There's been a lot of turmoil in financial markets. We've watched it go up and down, and people can focus on their portfolio and go, it's down 7% this year. Everything must be just doing terrible. Financial markets move up and down for a variety of reasons. Right now, because of so much turmoil going on in China, and the uncertainty around when is the Federal Reserve going to move. I ask people to put those things aside and focus on the long-term outlook for the U.S. consumer, because that's really all that matters. The U.S. consumer still drives the global economy, and the U.S. consumer is enjoying a pickup in labor markets, a recovery in the housing market, and finally, inexpensive gasoline, and it is permanent, not temporary.
Very exciting news. And I'm certainly glad to hear it for all of the women in commercial real estate who have been very concerned about the economy. Many companies don't realize how valuable women are to the economy. We don't see as many women on boards of directors. We don't see as many women on the C-suite. But would you talk a little bit about the role of women in our economy?
Well, the role of women really transformed the economy beginning back in the 1970s when women began to pour into the labor force in huge numbers. Now, sociologists have talked about all kinds of reasons why that happened, smaller family size, but from an economist's point of view, the economy fundamentally changed. And what made you a productive worker used to be brawn when it was farming and manufacturing. In a knowledge economy, the soft skills that women tend to have intuitively mean that they many times are superior workers, more productive workers in the kind of industries that are really growing. And that began really a long time ago, back in the 1970s. We've seen women's labor force participation pick up to the point where it's now on par with men's. And so they wield economic power because they wield income, but they still haven't quite made it up into the highest ranks of corporate America. And what I like to say is we broke through that glass ceiling only to find that there's kind of a glass roof up there when it comes to boards of directors, the C-suite. And even though companies give a lot of lip service to wanting to bring more diversity and more women into the boardroom, somehow it's not translating really into action. So they're talking, but the actions aren't fitting with the talk. And I think that disconnect is becoming evident to everyone. And I think the possibility of having viable female presidential candidates on both sides of the aisle is pushing this issue to the forefront even more.
I think it's a wonderful observation you make about the political influence that women seem to be carrying. And it is a wonderful opportunity now for women. And we heard so many good ideas this morning, and we've been talking for such a long time. But I'm getting impatient. It says 100 years it will take until we get to the point that women will have pay equity.
Well, I think, Gail, you have to remember that, you know, it's like when we say with the stock market, you know, the past is not necessarily a predictor of the future. And I think that this idea that if things continue at this pace, it'll take 100 years for women to have parity. But I actually don't think it's going to continue at this pace. What I know about the U.S. economy and U.S. culture is that even though as we get older, we tend to be more resistant to change, the reality is that this economy and this nation has always been able to embrace change and do the thing that's in our best interest over the long term. Having women be on par with men economically, studies have shown that pushes your economy forward so quickly and everybody wins. You've seen those statistics around India that if they would just educate their women, their economy would grow and poverty would decline so much faster. So we know it's the right thing to do, and because it's the right thing to do, I tend to be optimistic that it's probably going to happen much quicker than we think.
We certainly appreciate those good wishes and hope indeed that's true. And if you had the ability to give advice to women all over the world, what is your one piece of advice you would give to women to encourage them and also to help them be successful and have the seat at the table they want?
I would say take that risk. Someone really wise once told me, you get one big shot in your life. Sometimes you'll get lucky enough and have a shot twice for the big one, but you're only gonna get one big opportunity in your life. And when it comes along, set aside that little voice in your head saying, you're not good enough, you can't do it. Take that risk. That's the thing that I would encourage, particularly young women. Take that risk.
I thank you very much. It's great advice, and I also encourage everyone who has an opportunity to listen to Marcy and to look at some of her books and to think through every bit of knowledge that you have about business and finance. Finance is a very important skill for women, and we are looking forward to having more women in the right seats at the right table. Thank you.